So we're back. I'm here with the fabulous Floyd. Floyd, you've got to excuse the accent. It's all part of dressing up.
Right.
After my horrible week, which you missed, but I'll show it out. So, Floyd, tell us about your look. You look fabulous today.
This is sort of a spangy look for me. I don't usually work this look, but it is hot, and it's the daytime, and it's summer.
So hot.
Right. It's September here in New York, and it's really hot, so I worked up.
It's really August.
So I'm working a sort of a fall look, not a full wig. A full wig's a little too sweaty for the summer, so.
So what inspires your makeup? Tell me, how do people get their ideas these days?
Oh, Annie Lennox. No, actually, I do sometimes. I do like that Annie Lennox look. She does have good makeup. But just whatever I'm feeling that day, you know. I don't really have a look. I have maybe some kind of chameleon of sorts.
And what were you doing last night at Copa with the shaving cream?
That was the real freaky look. I had these two shaving cream cans duct taped to my chest. You can still see a little of the glue from the tape wouldn't really come. Can we show tits on TV?
Anything, just not insertion.
I won't insert anything into my tits.
Okay.
I had these shaving cream and I had these clear tubes that came around and the shaving cream shot out my eyes and I had this paint pack in my wig and the blood came down, the black paint and the white foam and it was hot. It was real hot. I'm a performance artist.
Well, you're real hot today, I'll tell you
right.
that. So how long have you been doing this drag thing?
Well, I started doing drag in Atlanta when I was 14.
Atlanta?
So I've been doing it for 3 years. No, actually, I'm 28. I'm in my Saturn return. So I've been doing drag for 14 years now.
And where has it gotten you?
Here. Gay Cable Network.
So what's the difference between a performance artist and a drag queen, dude?
Well, I guess I don't try to look real, you know. Obviously. No, I do freaky things, you know, with like liquids and, you know, skewers and live piercings and things like that, you know, avant-garde. I've always been a big fan of the Dada school, so I like things absurd and, like that. Drag queens, I consider myself a drag queen because I do female impersonation, but it's more performance oriented where I don't do like Whitney or Miss Ross.
Barbara.
I've never been a Barbara queen. I do more like avant-garde stuff like Cocteau Twins and this Mortal Coil and stuff like that.
And what do you plan for the future?
Success.
Yeah, money.
I look to Lip Sync as my drag queen idol. The holy shroud of Lip Sync. No, actually, I am trying to put together a longer hour and a half show for like a venue such as Le Moment, or something like that.
You gotta pump those one man shows out.
Right.
The only way you get famous is this.
Right. Because I do like at the Pyramid, Channel 69, which has just ended. I do like half an hour shows that are really theatrical. It's like I stay on the stage for like the whole half hour, and I've done three of them recently that I really consider to be really good. I'm going to put them together and do an hour and a half show. At Le Moment or PS122 or The Kitchen or one of our other local
venues.
Yes.
What fabulous.